He's like, come in. It's kind of sexy. It's a sexy vibe. Hi, I'm Deepti from Love is Blind Season 2, and I'm about to react to some romantic comedies on Netflix. Rom-coms are my favorite genre. I mean, romantic and funny. Like, that's my vibe. I don't think I ever had any dreamy men like this in my high school.
Sorry. Okay, thank you.
This is my little nightmare.
You know, a romantic song came on, and I was like, oh, what's gonna happen? But it just didn't.
Love at first kiss. I love a teen romance. I think, like, you know, you're just coming into your own. You're trying to figure out your feelings. Like, you know, you have your first crush. Like, it's just all the fun, like, new firsts. It's very sweet and romantical and, like, Katy Perry style, like, fireworks. And then it's awkward.
Rick?
The classic airport scene.
Did I forget something? Yeah. You're a bastard.
Ooh. Call him out.
I know how hard you work, and I know what a badass you are, and I know you don't put up with any shit. So don't put up with his.
What a similar situation to mine when someone from an outside perspective has to be like, actually, he doesn't talk about you in the best light. You know what I mean? And it's like, you come to the realization, and then you're like, oh shit, I do deserve better.
Could you please strike wedding from his calendar?
Absolutely.
It's a great moment to see on television to be like, hey, you don't have to settle. You can choose yourself and you deserve more and you can be happy.
I am definitely rolling. Oh, but that is like nothing to
I love how she's dancing in the back.
On my face right now. All right, give me a minute. I think I... why is this so hard?
Because you've never said it before.
From somebody who holds in their feelings and their emotions a lot, I tend to express love through actions and not words. And so, and for some people, they need like affirmations. They need to hear it.
I felt like I was just some experiment. And I've never told anyone that.
Oh my gosh, because you're afraid that they don't feel it back. You're, you know, just scared of your own feelings. I think love is just so... it's complicated.
I think
I love you too.
It's so sweet.
Oh my God!
Okay, he's up now.
You think we would win the amazing race?
You don't?
You think
the amazing race.
We can't even agree on a restaurant.
What couple agrees on a restaurant?
You have a problem?
Yeah.
You don't get that?
Nope.
Get rid of the phones. It forces you to like communicate more. All date nights without phones.
Dick. Do you even watch the show?
Have I seen The Amazing Race?
It reminds me of myself in old relationships where I would like try to pretend like everything's okay kind of sometimes. It's just easy to get into small fights over like the smallest things.
Oh, and I'm supposed to be sweet to you after you just don't sit with me on the bus right up here.
Well, shouldn't you be thanking me that you got to sit next to who you actually wanted to?
Even if you're faking a relationship, there's still a relationship. You're still bonding. And so I think, you know, in the process of faking it, they're actually like being real.
You know, for someone who has such good grades, you can be so dense sometimes.
What?
Sometimes you just like don't see what's right in front of you. He's like, come in. It's kind of sexy. It's a sexy vibe. Just full dress. Kiss. The hot tub is way more of a romantic place to kiss. I mean, look at the steam. It's just glistening.
So where's your man?
Oh, there he is.
Oh, shit.
Hi, baby.
Oh, hell no. Don't you be kissing right in front of me. You always want to look good in front of your ex, and you always want to have the hotter significant other, I think. I'd be jealous. But you know what? It can look so good on the surface, but it's not always about status and fame and money. It's just about, you know, that soul connection.
Thank you.
Because the truth is, this is the real me.
Vulnerability, we love it.
And so is this.
I was bullied a lot in high school, so I can totally relate to how you want to just appear to be perfect. And secondly, finding love in high school, oh my gosh, that's got to be even harder because, like, you have no idea what you want or what you deserve or what you're looking for. So it's like there's just so many unknowns.
High school's just a bunch of scared people pretending to be something they're not.
I think you can see that she's really evolving and growing as a person because she cared so much about the superficiality of things and how everyone else viewed her, but towards the end realized that, you know, just being yourself and being authentic and vulnerable is actually going to get people to relate to you, and, you know, you become way more likable that way. You know, life is not a fairy tale and you always don't get a happy ending. At the same time, remember that movies are not always realistic, and just remember to live into your own truth and, like, create your own rom-com. Oh man, I just want to, like, go out there and find my person now. Where's my love story? Thank you so much for watching me react to romantic comedies here on Netflix Film Club. Be sure to check out all these movies and Love is Blind Season 2 on Netflix now.